Everybody, welcome back. It's a new weekly. It's a Monday, and it's a me, Mario. That's not gonna be the voice. Yes, it freaking was. Forget what. So they use Scatman's World. I can't conjure Scatman's World just out of thin air like that. Let me get a marmoset. I have no idea of what's in the pack this week. But I do know that Goose tends to be okay. Marmoset has good stats. Let me be like a cliche tentacle. Like, oh, what's this thing gonna do? You know what it's gonna do as soon as you see it. It's a cliche at this point. Now, did they best me via their placement? No, they did not. Forgot what I was talking about. It's a new weekly. It's the same old me. Let me tell you something that's kind of interesting here. You're going to, depending on the order in which things go here, you had three? Here's an interesting idea for you. A moth of our own, and then a goose that neutralizes them if they have a moth. I'm just thinking out loud. And the problem with this, and this is not the first time we've seen this come to pass, although we are going to win here anyway. The problem with this is that usually the moth goes maybe after the geese, depending. Okay, this is just crazy talk here. Sure, clownfish seems good enough. Let's buy two more geese, and we got one big goose up there. You know what? I'm going to try a... Oh, I'm stupid. Never mind. I am not going to try a stilt to the back. What was I thinking? Angry video game nerd voice. Angry video game nerd after losing all of his money in cryptocurrency scams in the shower. What was I thinking? It's a freaking coin of diarrhea made of a bull's cockadoodoo. Anyway, sorry. I'm just losing it a little bit. Roll me. I kind of want the stilt, but at the same time, I'm looking at this and I'm saying, I mean, the clownfish is kind of the meat and potatoes of our scaling right now. It's real hard for me to pivot off of the, well, maybe it isn't, to pivot off of this like leveling up thing that we've got going on here, but it's sort of, it's stalled out a little bit. Here's what I think we should do. Maybe I see a shrimp, which tells me that, and a starfish, maybe buy sell has some potential this week. I mean, you could, in principle, you could buy a starfish, sell a marmoset. What we should probably be doing is fitting a shrimp in somewhere too, but or buying a capybara so we get some power off the rerolls here. And you have no sell abilities, but you're still quite nice. Let's try this now. Nobody needs a pineapple. Roll me. That's what we're looking for. Am I willing to sell? You know what? I think I am, because I don't think our starfish actually does anything for us long term. Let's buy this. On knockout, summon a 3/3 level 1 copy of the knocked out pet. I don't necessarily see that going yard. And the giraffe is not a bad play here either, but allow me to, you know, have some time with the pets that we didn't get a chance to really use last week. There's a lot of archetypes going on here. I see like there's a summon archetype with the sea turtle. Potentially a little buy sell. And the falcon is going to get huge attack buffs from our moth. So we really want it to get some HP so that it's theoretically possible that its trigger could go off. Although actually we're probably going to put it in this position, aren't we? Because it needs to have the space to summon anything at all, really. Suppose we could also, it's kind of interesting to think about the idea of putting your falcon at the back. And then if you end up going up against scalers, you use like their own scalers against them. I think for now I'm going to live with this, and I'm going to say that maybe just some raw stats is nice here, but I'm not discontented with this squad. It's a little bit out of my comfort zone, but I'm not upset. Okay, now I'm a little bit upset. You got me, if that was your goal, you got me there. Some interesting ideas here. Like, for example, this is 3 gold, 3 attack. 3 gold, 3 attack. Roll. Now, was that any good? I don't know. But we use the waffle, which always feels nice. I mean, it's a tasty food. I don't think anyone would deny that. Who's going to say a waffle's not tasty? Nobody, in my opinion. Nobody being honest with themselves, at the very least. Okay, you got me. I'm on lethal. Now I'm a little bit disappointed with the squad. Lollipop, it's been a while. Penguin, it's been even longer. Two level two and three friends get 1-1. I'm willing to give you a chance. I know we had the opportunity there to go in some different areas, some different paths. I feel like our team's not that bad. I'm hoping now once we go up, we're in loser's bracket. I'm hoping down here in loser's bracket we got a shot. Like, look at this, okay? We got a little extra power. We're gonna lose, really? Really? Okay, what have I learned from this? Monday's not always a gimme. Let's put it that way. The other thing I learned from this is it's never too early to scale. I would say for now, let's take a mosquito. We'll talk about a chinchilla for sure. And let me be like a sniffing herbs? That's me. Me in the grocery store trying to tell whether or not what I'm holding is cilantro or Italian parsley. People will be like, they look so different. I guarantee if I gave you a bundle of Italian parsley and a bundle of cilantro, as you so erroneously like to call it. We say cilantro up there. Maybe it's the opposite. I can never remember. Coriander. Let me tell you. I think you're getting 70% right at most. As you could probably guess from my smug demeanor and choice of words, I think you're getting... I think you probably do 50. But that's only because it's an either-or to begin with. So 50 is like a pretty reasonable base case. You know what? We're going pog crazy mode. I mean, this is as pog crazy as pog crazy gets. We should just make one super huge unit. Ox is really good. And we haven't had it in forever. But I feel like capybara is just like... it's just more sensible. I dare not, though, and believe you me, the temptation is there. I dare not start building another chinchilla, as funny as it sounds. You know something that's kind of interesting to think about as we lose yet another round? Is what if you could do like a scaled pivot here? And what do I mean by this insane statement? You could sell... get three chinchillas, combine the chinchillas to level up, and then it's like you got three gold, but you didn't lose that much on your sales. Now maybe what I'm... or you didn't lose that many stats on your scalings, I should say. Now, what I said there may have made fundamentally very little sense to you, and that's okay. Very happy with our turtles. Not so happy with the rest of the squad, though. This looks like a team that is going to maybe give me another loss, and I'm on zero wins. But the stats look good. How can such a thing be happening? Wow! Okay, obviously we need to get some scaling off here. Like, okay, there's our scaling. Holy cow, our scaling. There it is. And I did think about... does she have 6 health? It is tempting to throw a stork out there, huh? I think the capybara has done well for us, and for that I'm eternally grateful. But let's lean into the turtle actually helping us here. We should probably talk about the giraffe as well. And the dragonfly, like, this is our squad right here. The three that we got in the front row, we're happy with that. That's where we want to be. You got enough HP to turn an 0-for-1 into a 2-for-1, which is beautiful. And now we're kind of cruising. Now we're kind of chilling with it. Give me this and this. Roll me once. It's a very tough choice. I'm going to peel off the Band-Aid sooner rather than later. I'm going to start buffing thusly. I think that we had to choose either the clownfish or the stork, and I'm happy with the stork to synergize right now. And it may come back to bite me a little bit, but I think that we're not really trying to have the stork win the game for us. Oh my god, I hate you. It's more that we hope that it keeps us like alive, and mission failed so far. We hope that it keeps us alive long enough to be able to throw out like another unit. But I'm just thinking, or to be able to throw out higher tier units. I think we have to sell the giraffe, and I'll be the first person to tell you that was not the right way to build this, but like, we shouldn't have invested more in the giraffe if we were just going to sell it. But, you know, when you're on lethal, it's desperate times, and they call for desperate measures, I've heard. The heck is that, a 1-9 ox? Okay, at the very least, we beat a team that was being dragged down by a sloth. So, all is not lost. Come on, man. These are desperate circumstances. There is a temptation at this point to unwind the stork, but and send out a second dragonfly instead. I have opted not to do that, and I may regret that, but I'm betting on an 18-17, and I'm betting on a 15-15 to not be so bad. And that obviously hasn't really worked so far. Please do not summon a 1-9 ox ever again in my entire life. I beg you. This is huge. It definitely does feel like a shark could go crazy. I just have to think about it. Like, I don't mind not getting all of the value out of the extra chinchillas being sold. The only thing is this the right play? Let's just assume things go right. So you would get, if we sold you and put the shark there, we would get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You'd be stronger than the chinchilla. I mean, I think this is what you have to do to make it at this stage of the game anyway. Just roll me once, just see what you get. The catch here is that we're not going to be getting as nice of a buff out of the dragonfly because we don't have a level 3. But we're close, and we're close to a level 3 dragonfly. I think I can live with this as long as there's no snipers on the enemy team. Don't do me like this. Don't. I'm begging you for mercy. It's all I got, okay? 3 wins. I mean, there's no... I can't really be like, that's amazing. It's my fault. I tried to have some fun with it. That's a classic mistake that you don't want to make in Super Auto Pets. Okay, let's see. Scaling. This week, it appears scaling is back on the menu. Coming up next with a cut from his new album, Sting. Take it away. Give me this. Freeze this. And let me be like a giggling underdog, because that's how I feel right now. I don't think... this... Last week... That's a bad hit right there. That is not the way I would have done it. Last week, we started strong, and then things got a lot harder. This week, if I'm being honest with you, it sort of feels like I'm not really feeling strong in the early game. I feel like I've had so many more rounds than typical, where I'm at 4 HP when I make it to round 3. Which is what's going to happen again. I seem to be consistently losing 2 rounds in the early game. So we should mix that up. And then in the late game, it all falls apart. I just get killed by much faster scaling. So here's something for you. How about we start building a shrimp squad? When in doubt, go shrimp, said no one ever. Shouldn't have sold in that order. We were saved, unpunished. 3-2, this summons a 2-2 dog. Even with the chocolate cake, I probably snooze on that one. I'm snoozing. I'm not snoozing. I'm selling and selling. Oh, you piece of garbage. I'm buying and selling. And you shouldn't, that shouldn't be allowed. That's sequence breaking. It's like you don't care about the stack. Second shrimp is going to hit the spot. We're looking for things with sales. 2 shrimp and a bunch of chinchillas. Sounds like an Outdoor Life Network show. Hey, I'm going up against a team that, dare I suggest, they might be almost as bad as I am. Nope. Not quite. All right. I would definitely say combine and buy. Now, wait, I gotta buy you. I gotta put you somewhere. Maybe I'm okay with you just taking a level. And that's not a sales technique. You gotta ask yourself, like, are you really... Because we could have gone woodpecker, especially knowing that there's a pineapple. But now that we got two shrimps, I'm like, I can't bear the thought of not having them. I'm committing to insanity here, and if I have to lose, I'm at least going to lose my way, okay? I'll take my level. I'll sell my heroic beetle. What do you think about actually buffing a unit that's like half decent? No, not necessary. Go hard on the stats. Do not buff. Okay, buffing each other is like almost equally offensive to me, but... Level, sure. We're going to be four squatted, but ooh, I was going to say, depending on the unit, it might be okay. Oh, nothing wrong with that. Except that we're four squatted. But a penguin, I've seen a lot of penguins on teams that have beaten us this week. There is something worth noting, and I would say that thing that's worth noting is that I've been beaten by a lot of teams that just mathematically speaking, probably are not that good this week, because I've been beaten by almost every team I've come up against so far. So, except for that one. You should take, if you're sticking, you should take some broccoli. Absolutely. And we'll get the level next time. I hope that buy sell can continue, but I think we'd probably need to embrace the fact that that could fall off. Here's a positive thing I'm going to say about this week right now. And it's not all bad, although we are two lives already. It seems like there's lots of archetypes. You know, we've seen scaling. We haven't really seen sniping, but we're going to be the change we want to see in the world. Maybe there's a buy-sell mechanic in here. Just lots of semi-interesting stuff. I'm rolling. Rolling, I can't. At this point, we want to keep a mosquito. Just because, like, we don't have the space anymore to do our buy-sells. As much as I wish that we did. So the penguins are really going to juice moth, and they're really going to juice... Ooh, what a shot. Mosquito. So those units right now, I feel like it's hard to pivot off of them, if it's even possible at all. I'm realizing... You know what's nice about this weekly as well? It doesn't appear to simply be dominated by... Skunk is nice. It's just a nice unit, but there is a part of me that thinks you could, like... Well, I don't really want a lollipop. I guess I'm going to roll. Don't really care for mosquito to level. It could probably get sold if we could get another level 2 unit to soak up the stance instead. Thought about the Doberman pivot, too. I just don't know if it's going to be plausible, but... It's nice to have a weekly that at least at this level doesn't seem to just be dominated by, like, who gets garlic in their shop first. That may change, but for now... Here we are. And maybe there's lemons at turn 6 and I'll look like a fool. There aren't tomatoes, though. Interesting. Okay, how about this? I don't really see this being a big fly setup here. I could be wrong. You know what I do see is an opportunity to really go hard on the scaling here. I'd rather have the monkey than the dragonfly, I think. Like, a 50-50 with melon armor should, in theory, be really strong this week. That's what my brain's telling me. And it's only wrong slightly less than half the time for issues like this. So it's pretty reliable. Wouldn't say it's rare. Well, it's hard to bet against scaling this week. But it's also nice to have a very strong crocodile. It's just, at this point, I say it's just more fun than a monkey. So let's... Don't look now. We built a little bit of momentum here. I love the octopus too. It's just at this point, it's hard to run from the squad we already got. I'm starting to think we might have. This is going to be the beginning of a beautiful friendship. You should take the chili pepper for now. Obviously, like a melon eventually. Why don't you continue to justify your existence in some way, and you as well? We need every unit to be able to do something here. It also seems like I'm creating tentative power rankings like in my own head right now. If there is no lemon, if there's no melon, or sorry, no garlic, because there are melons, defense is very important. That's interesting. Coconut is defense. But another way to get defense is to build a big hippo. Now, it wouldn't be the first time, for sure, that a big hippo was the meta. In fact, it would be more surprising at this point if a big hippo was not the meta. And I know what you're going to say, by the way. You're going to be like, you rolled past the melon. I know. I think that the chili pepper maybe for where we're at in the power. I mean, I'm just spitballing. You got to make a decision one way or the other. I'm spitballing. And what my spitball is telling me is that for where we're at in the game right now, the chili pepper can do, it can provide more value. I'm hoping. This is a very, like, it's kind of an old school squad here. Why don't you, I mean, honestly, yeah, you don't need to flip your stats. Nobody needs to flip their stats. Why don't you take a chili pepper? That's like draw copium. We can now move our mosquito to the front, probably. Holy cow, this is a scary team. Or is it? Actually, it turns out if you snipe the units behind the walrus before the match even starts, not a scary team at all. And I can't believe it. Here we are looking for 10. Not necessary. Not necessary. Chocolate's really the only one. We're on 2 life. I would roll. I would buy. I guess there's not much point in getting to a level 3 monkey, but you got to pick your battles here. We should move the mosquito. Well, it's a tough choice. I don't want to get into the metagame of it. Oh, no. This time it would have been a lot better to have a mosquito at the front. That's a strong team, dude. Basically, it depends. Like, maybe it doesn't depend. I don't know. You know what? You're going to get how much? 6 health? You take a melon then. This is like, we're all in. What are we looking for? I mean, that really would be a level 3 crocodile. Rather than have a chili pepper on you, a tomato on you might snipe out a backline unit and get us like a cheeky win or a cheeky draw. But we're in a little bit of like, you know, it's we're at the Hopium Sanctuary. So close. It doesn't matter. It doesn't. We got it. I'm a genius. I can't believe it. 10 wins. Okay, so it's like some redemption. And what did we learn? Well, there's a lot of scaling units, so buy them. For now, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. Helps to the great deal. Of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. See ya.